steakhouse food is so rich and satisfying that I've decided to make some of my steakhouse favorites at home with a unique Italian twist. I'm gonna bake a luscious focaccia studded with bits of garlic, fresh rosemary, and grapes. For a side dish, I'm gonna bake tiny orzo pasta with sauteed mushrooms, nutty fontina cheese, and peas. For the main course, a meaty ribeye steak seasoned with herbs and topped with a tangy black olive vinaigrette. And for the finale, a lemon-lime frozen custard topped with crumbled amaretti cookies. These are my versions of steakhouse classics, a dinner that's a cut above the rest. You've got to have great bread to go along with a great steak. Here's one that I love because it's hardy enough to hold its own, and it couldn't be easier to make. Focaccia with rosemary and grapes comes out of the oven warm, smelling and tasting divine. One of my favorite things about steakhouses are all the breads that come to the table right at the beginning of the meal. And I'm gonna make one of my favorites today. I'm using shallots and garlic, and I'm only using one shallot, so not too much. Nice oniony flavor, but really mild. And instead of chopping it up, I like to just slice it. And it doesn't take as long as onion to cook. So in that 20 to 25 minutes, it kind of just caramelizes and all the flavor seeps straight into the focaccia bread. We've got the shallot. Then I like to add one garlic clove. That's all you need. Just a little bit of that garlicky flavor. What's a steakhouse without some garlic, right? So, you know, it's funny when I go to a steakhouse for dinner, Todd will always get the big steak and I'll have a few bites of his steak, but it's all the sides that I love. So the breads and the pastas, you know, and of course the desserts. Okay, so now that I've got that, put a little flour on the board. There we go. And the pizza dough. And I like to make my focaccia into a rectangle. Let's just add a little bit of flour to my rolling pin. Do it that way. So, again, just like pizza, we're gonna roll it onto the little rolling pin and then put it on the parchment on a baking sheet. Okay, so now I get to top it with all the things that I love. Lots of extra virgin olive oil. I just take a little brush and just kind of brush the olive oil all over. Now that we've added that, I wanna add some coarse sea salt. Just get it all over. Okay, and now we'll do the shallots and the garlic. Just mix it up, you know, so every bite gets a little bit of everything on it. We also need some herbs, of course. So I'm just gonna add a little bit of rosemary over the top. Great color and great flavor. Mm, it's really fragrant too. Now this is the really fun part, and I know it's gonna sound really weird, but I'm gonna add grapes. Green and red grapes on top. Somehow the sweet juices penetrate the focaccia dough, and that's it. Just wanna press them down when you do it. Okay, so I'm gonna bake this at 400 degrees for 20 to 25 minutes until it's all golden brown and super yummy. Today I'm raising my favorite steakhouse foods to a whole new level. For a side dish, I want something luscious that will complement my steak. Baked orzo with fontina and peas is absolutely decadent and delicious. Oh my gosh, the shallots and the rosemary and the garlic, heavenly. While that cools down, I'm gonna get started on one of my favorite sides. I'm gonna make this creamy orzo. So we're gonna start with some butter and chop up onion and mushrooms. Gonna add a little bit of salt just to slowly start to wilt and soften the onions. So now I'm gonna grab mushrooms and I just quarter them. That's all you need to do. And I'm just using some nice brown mushrooms, but you can use any kind of assorted mushrooms that you like. We're also gonna add the mushrooms in with the butter. And a little bit more salt. Remember, you wanna flavor every single layer so you're not stuck adding tons of salt to your dish right at the end after everything's already cooked, and then it doesn't absorb the flavor anyway. Just wanna mix that all together. Okay, so that's gonna take about 7 to 8 minutes for the mushrooms and the onions to cook down. So while that cooks, I've got 4 cups of low sodium chicken broth. And to that, I'm gonna add orzo. It's one of my favorite little pastas. And see, they look like little grains of rice. So 1 pound of orzo into 4 cups of low sodium chicken broth that's boiling. I only have to cook it for 7 minutes until it's slightly cooked. It'll finish cooking in the oven later on. And up next, I'm gonna show you how to put this fantastic creamy orzo together.